Hi guys, I've used the EOS R5 for the last few weeks. If you're interested in my unboxing, you can find up there by clicking the eye icon and also include the link under the description. This video tests the ISO invariance of EOS R5. In simple terms, how annoying the noise with different ISO settings. If you think the video is worthless, as always, lower the ISO is always the better, then you are mistaken. I will show you at a particular noise level, higher ISO may perform better than the lower one. If you'd like to jump to any specific session, I've included timestamp links in the description below. Without further ado, let's get started. You may understand the exposure triangle when you first start your photography journey. It is the relationship among the aperture, shutter speed, and the ISO. However, things are changed when using DSLR. Previously, ISO is referring to the film sensitivity. You can buy a higher ISO film if you need to shoot an indoor environment or some night scene. There's no film in DSLR, and it is the same sensor for different ISO settings. The number of photons hitting the sensor is controlled by the shutter speed and the aperture. The photons hit the photodiode will transfer to the number of electrons and stored in the bucket until the shutter is closed. By then, the electric charge is converted to an analog voltage. Next, it will go through a stack of amplifier and analog digital converter. Eventually, it becomes the grid of digital values per each sensor pixel. The ISO settings is controlling the last part of the gain and multiplier applied to the conversions. In common understanding, a higher ISO will lead to a higher noise. Technically, keeping the final exposure constants, higher the ISO will lower the signal-to-noise ratio. As a result, we try to shoot at the lowest ISO possible to reduce the noise. However, the noise level is not directly proportional to the ISO settings, just like the performance in the lens at different focal lengths. It has a sweet spot. The ISO performance is also specific to different models of the camera body, not the brand. Although there exists very scientific testing online such as Nixomark and photons2photos.net, this video illustrates the visual results to you. By the way, the links to the reference site are listed in the description. Let's get shooting. I shot a series of photos at the same exposure, same shutter speed, and only different in the ISO setting. I first set the highest ISO and shot a correctly exposed photo. In this video, the first photo shot at ISO 51200, 1/16 second, f2.8, 35mm on a tripod and shot using a wired trigger. High night tone priority is off, auto nighting optimizer off, long exposure noise reduction off, high ISO speed noise reduction off, and not using the mechanical shutter. I shot at my apartment, and the room temperature is around 27 degrees Celsius. After the first shot, I decreased the ISO settings and shot again. Just repeat this process until the ISO is down to 100. There are total 28 shots. The ISO under the test is ranged from 100 to 51,200, with 1/3 steps each. I've got 28 different exposure photos. I copy those to my laptop. As Adobe Lightroom does not support the RAW format of the EOS R5 yet, I have to use the DNG converter and convert all to DNG files. Then it can be imported to the Adobe Lightroom. I use the Adobe Lightroom Classic 9.3, Camera RAW 12.3. After import all photos, simply select all the files with the first file selected. That is, the ISO is 51,200. Then go to the develop mode, and then in the menu, set settings, match total exposure. Lightroom use the EXIF info in the photos, and adjust all the image to the same exposure as the first photo. But there's a problem. In Lightroom, the max exposure is +5. If you check the exposure settings in the photos, it is increasing in constant 1/3 steps each. In the 16 photos, the ISO is equal to 1250, the exposure adjustment is set to plus 5. In the 17 photos, the ISO is equal to 1000, it is also set to plus 5. I need to do some manual changes from these photos onward. The trick is to use the off-screen graduated filter to give further exposure boost. I create an off-screen graduated filter in the 17th image, set the exposure to 1/3 depth, sync it to the remaining 11 photos, and change the graduate filter exposure manually. The final step sets the white balance of all images to the same value. I set it to the fluorescent. At this moment, I got 28 theoretically identical exposure photos. I've included the DNG files and the JPG files for all the photos in the description. So if you like, you can download it and test it out yourself. If you check through the first 20 photos, from ISO equals to 51,200 to ISO equals to 800, the noise level looks almost identical. Observable difference starting in ISO 640 onward. We should ignore the image contrast, as if you check the histogram, multiple bytes present means there are not enough data in the captured photo, and the extreme exposure stretch caused the data may need to compute and interpolate. Let's check the 100% crop area. Three areas are picked. Each area is 500 pixel by 500 pixel. The first is the dark hillside with a single street lamp. A handrail is behind the street lamp. The same pattern shown here, the noise level looks identical from ISO 800 to 51,200. Second group is from 400 to 640. Change in some color tone exists to 640 show a greenish tint, while 500 and 400 shows a purplish hue. The third group is from ISO 320 to 100. The noise level at ISO 320 is worse than 400. Starting from ISO 160, the handrail is hardly distinguishable. The second area is the wall of a factory building. It also includes multiple office lights and stairways lights. This area has much more detail compared to the first street light square. The same pattern here, it can be partitioned into three groups. The noise level looks identical from 800 to 51,200. The second group is from ISO 400 to 640. Change in the color tone is noticeable. The third group is from ISO 320 to 100. The last area is the peak and the night sky. Not much detail in this area, and this is the best to check the noise level. The same pattern is also found here. It can be partitioned into three groups. The noise level looks identical from ISO 800 to 51,200. The second group is from 400 to 640, change in some color tone again. The third group is from 320 to 100. I guess there are a total of 2 to 3 different sensitivity controls inside the EOS R5. ISO 800 to 51,200 is ISO invariance. ISO 400 to 600 looks strange in the color control, though can be easily fixed in the post-processing. ISO 100 to 320 is the third group, and the noise at the 320 is worse than 400. The finding is consistent with the result in the photons to the photos.net, especially in the range of ISO 800 to the 51,200 range. So what's the impact to your shooting practice using the EOS R5? Usually not much. Shoot as usual to get the correct exposure, but avoid using ISO 320. Use 400 instead. From the range of 800 to 51,200, as it is ISO invariance, just pick the best combination of aperture and shutter speed. ISO setting is irrelevant in this range. Let me illustrate the idea. For example, if you like to shoot the Milky Way, by the way, I've shot a video about shooting the Milky Way in Hong Kong. You can check the above eye icon here. Let's say, use a 35mm lens and using the 500 grinding rules. The most extended shutter speed is 14 seconds with no observable star trail or motion blur. Aperture is set at the largest f2.8. shutter speed is 40 seconds and the ISO is 1060, but the histogram show is still a little bit dark and is shifted to the left. In this case, it is safe to crank up the ISO as long as it's not clipping the highlights. The reason is the ISO 1600 is already in the invariance range. Note that this only applies to the US R5 according to this testing result. Pay attention that don't get confused in the following scenarios. Let's say shooting a night scene handheld. Which setting will you choose? Okay, set A, f2.8, 1 over 100 seconds and ISO 800. Set B, f2.8, 1 over 200 seconds, ISO 1600. Though both ISO settings is in the invariance range, setting A is preferred, as the number of photons caught in A is double than B, so the signal-to-noise ratio is much better than B. So what's next? I know 10 stops ISO invariant test is too aggressive. I'm thinking another testing ranging from ISO 100 to 1600. Please let me know your comments or any testing that you would like me to do with the US R5.
I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like it, remember to click the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks, and see you next time.